What up, Ty Nation? I'm EDM producer TYLR. Let's react to some music, shall we? Here we go. Take me high. Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today I am so beyond excited because I was checking out my YouTube feed on Friday and I was like, ooh, new Angelina. And I saw Now I'm the Fool. I'm like, ooh, maybe this is a cover. And then so I clicked on it out of curiosity and I checked the description. No, it's her EP. It's finally here, guys. I was like, because you guys thought maybe it was coming in July. I think you guys told me you thought it might be coming in June. So I was like waiting all throughout June and it never came. I was like, oh no, did she not do it? I was like really disappointed. And then now it's here. And I'm like, yes, oh my gosh, thank God. And I looked it up on Apple Music. There's 6 songs. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. This is the best day ever. So I'm really excited. So first off, we're going to definitely start with Now I'm the Fool official video, and then if we want to react to some more afterwards, we'll dive into those too, but we'll get to that in the video. So first of all, let's dive into this because I'm really excited. I don't waste any more time. Let's go, guys. Here we go. Alrighty, you know we're here for Angelina. What you got for us, girl? Let's do this. Whoa, let's go. Okay. Probably should reboot it, make sure it's loaded properly. Oh yeah, got that classic style.
What can I do when you tell me I deserve someone better than you? You wouldn't know how to break a heart in two. Never had a plan too far for you. I don't understand. Look in your eyes now, I'm a fool.
Oh, you better sing, girl.
It's just another day in the world, but I'm stuck hiding in the shade of your words. You protected me from all the pain, but I learned that I was just a mistake. You told me I wasted time on loving you.
Oh, wow. Okay, hold your horses now. Oh my gosh, first of all, this is freaking fantastic. Oh my gosh, the lyrical writing in this song is phenomenal. I mean, is somebody writing these lyrics for her, or is she writing all these songs for herself? Because, I mean, she's only 17 years old, maybe 18 now? I don't know when her birthday is. And she's writing about, like, this, like, heartbreak and, like, wasting her time on a man and whatnot. And, like, basically the song being Now I'm the Fool, she was, like, a fool for wasting her time with this guy. I mean, being 17 years old, I feel like she's probably not really had a relationship that could lead to her feeling like this yet, you know? So I'm wondering if this is, like, I don't know if somebody maybe wrote this for her, or maybe she just wrote this in the perspective of, you know, a song for people going through this, who have gone through this, I should say. But, like, I think that's what I love about her so much, because, like, most of the time, I'm not a very big fan of, like, the younger singers, because, like, typically they'll write maybe a little bit more immature. I'm not saying that all singers this age do. Trust me, there's a bunch of phenomenal singers out there that are about her age or even younger that have great, great songs out there. I mean, look at girls like Billie Eilish. I mean, Justin Bieber was about, like, 12 when he was discovered, so I expected him to write something like Baby Baby, which was kind of a little immature. But as he grew up, he got a little bit more mature with his songs. Even someone like, you know, like Miley Cyrus, as she got older, she wrote some pretty mature songs. Demi Lovato was writing some great ones. So a lot of girls that started off around the same age as Angelina wrote some great, really, like, well-written songs. But I think she's the first one where I feel like she's not from this era. You know, she is... It's like she's like a woman that is trapped in from like the days of soul music and stuff. I don't know what year that was, like the 1970s or 80s. I'm not sure. It's like she's like trapped in. It's like she is like that embodiment of somebody from that era in a 17-year-old girl's body from this era. You know, if that makes any sense. You know, because it's like just the lyrical writing is so mature and so like, you know, meaningful and like relatable, if you want to put it that way. It's the best word for me to use. And like her style is very much of that time period. The way she sings obviously is very much from that time period. It's like, you know, she was almost like. It's like she was born in the wrong era. It's like she doesn't belong in Gen, like, Z. She belongs in generation, what would that be? Generation, would that be baby boomers? Would that be who was listening to that type of music back in the day? I don't know. I'm not trying to offend anybody. I don't want to say anything wrong. But, yeah, I think that's just what I love so much about her. It's the uniqueness, the fact that she's trying to, actually she's successfully bringing back an era of music that kind of got lost for a while there. And the fact that she's, just, it's like she's her own person. She's her own singer. She's her own artist. You know, nobody's out there, like, singing like her, you know, just, like, performing like her. Everything about her is unique. It's all Angelina. That is what it is. You hear her, and you know it's her. Yeah, that's, oh, it's so good. I'm gonna go back one, and we gotta keep going with this. This is so good. Oh my gosh. I'm sorry for the long rant. Just lots to talk about. I'm just super excited right now.
Broken pieces that I lost. Now that you're gone.
Oh, that was awesome. Now that you're gone. Oh man, this is what I love about her too. Is she's really turning into like a true performer. Like you could just see like as she grows up and as she writes more music and as she does more and more like performances in like these videos, she's really turning into more just not just a singer, but a performer, and that is gonna really come in handy for her when she's like doing world tour, because she's gonna be out there performing her butt off for all of us, and she's gonna be singing her heart out. Everybody's gonna be singing back to her because she has really relatable and catchy songs that are fun to sing too. They're not overly complex where you can't really sing along with her. And, like, I think that's, like, the idea, is that she wants to basically create music that has impact and is easy to sing along to and will stick with you. That's exactly what she does. Every song I've heard from her that's her own song has stuck with me and really hit me hard, and that's what she's so good at. But, like, I love seeing her as a performer like this. Like, something easy that's just like, now he's gone. Just like, oh, yeah, get out of my face. You're out of here. Like, just something easy as that is just, like, really adds impact to the song itself and the actual video. And you can really see her just, like, really embracing herself as an artist now. It's like, you know, at the age of only 17, 18 years old, however old she is right now, the fact she's already found her sound, found her image, found herself as an artist and who she wants to be is really impressive. Some people may spend their, like, whole lifetime trying to figure out who they want to be as an artist. I'm even trying to figure that out. I'm much older than she is. Like, you know, it's like, I'm almost proud, you know? It's like, I almost feel like I'm, like, a proud parent of her, you know? Even though I'm not old enough to be her parent, obviously. But, like, you know, I feel like that's how we may all feel. It's like, we're almost proud of how far she's come. From the little, like, 10-year-old girl, 9-year-old girl at Nora's Got Talent to now. And she's on a massive label. She's about to be embarking on not only an EP, but, like, her first album. And then possibly a world tour, most likely. I mean, I guess I just feel proud, I feel like. It's just, oh, so great. Anyways, okay, I'm talking so much. I'm sorry. I'll stop now. I'll let it go through. I'll only pause if I absolutely need to now. I'll let it go through all the way now.
I see you. I feel you in everything that I do.
Oh.
If I had a plane too far for you, I don't understand. Don't have a clue. I'll look in your eyes now. I'm a fool.
Don't mind me, she's trying to learn the lyrics.
And I just called to let you know it hurts.
Yes, girl. Ooh, wowzer. Oh my gosh, guys. Let's talk about this. Alrighty, guys, that was my reaction to Angelina Jordan's new song off of her new, brand new EP, Or Enough, and that song was called Now I'm the Fool. I gotta say, this is what I've needed in my life. Somebody fresh like her who comes out of a talent show and is like, and you know, she had a little bit of a little bit of waiting period to get herself going and whatnot, you know, but you know, the fact that now she's on Republic Records releasing her first ever EP, an album following soon, plus a world tour, she is about to explode. I know it, I can feel it. She is ready to take over the world. She's going to become a hit amongst all generations, because she's bringing back a style of music that has almost been lost, or at least was, like, you know, nobody really brought it back around yet, and she's bringing that back to our generation now. You know, people are gonna be able to grow up hearing her music, because anybody that really falls in love with her right now, like from my generation, people have, like, my age having kids, they're gonna maybe grow up listening to that type of music, and that's gonna almost maybe respawn that love for that type of music she's presenting to us in a way. And so, like, we have the capability here of bringing that back, which is so exciting. And, like, this is really a style of music I never really got a chance to listen to. And you know, to hear her take it as it is and almost bring a more modernized version of it is so cool. Like, she's still keeping that, like, old school style of just that simple guitar, maybe a piano, and then obviously the way she sings. Even, like, that black and white music video is so freaking cool. The styling of her hair and everything, it's all screaming and going back to that generation of music, but it's like she's bringing it back in her own way, if that makes sense. But I love seeing the passion she has, the performing she does now, the way she's really, really strongly developed her vocal. And I feel like every time I hear her sing something new, her vocal is getting more powerful and more just passionate. It's like she really embodies everything she sings. And, like, I cannot wait to listen to the rest of this EP. There's, like, still 5 more songs, which is so awesome. I mean, she's truly gifted us something, like, really special, I think. She really has. So my only question to you guys is, do you want me to do a reaction to each song individually, so I can break them down for each, like, way they are, if you will? Or do you want me just to do a full, like, 20-30 minute video of just all the 5 songs remaining and just, like, kind of just do a full synopsis of, like, the album? So, yeah, so either every song individually, or do you want me just to do the full rest of the EP all at one time? You know, because I think that, you know, I think it might be better for me to dive into each song individually, but if I do that, we might be spotting that out for a good, you know, 5 weeks or so, less if I can double up my Angelina videos every week. So, totally up to you guys, guys. Just let me know, because obviously your time is precious. I know it's not very easy for people to watch a whole 20-30 minute video with everything going on in everybody's lives, so whatever you guys want, I will do for you, and I just can't wait to listen to this. So, yeah. Anyways, guys, thank you all for watching. Please take the time to like, subscribe, and make sure you click that notification to be alerted whenever I start a group artist or new band on my channel. Besides that, you guys are awesome. I love you guys, and as always, bye.